Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, auto numbering in Excel, watch the video till the end. And also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Let's study auto numbering in Excel. So where can you do a simple numbering in Excel where we manually provide a cell number for the series numbers and we can also make it to do automatically to do an auto numbering? So we have two methods. First, we can fill the first two cells with the series of the numbers we want to get inserted and drag it down to the end of the table. And the second method is to use the row formula, which will give us the number and then drag the formula in the similar way to the end of the table. What exactly is the auto numbering in Excel? Let's understand this. So in our today's session, we'll be learning how to do the auto numbering in Excel. The top three ways to get the auto numbering in Excel, which is very vital thing to understand, an imperative part of this particular topic. Once those top three ways are done, I'll make you understand that what are the things that you should remember for auto numbering. So let's begin. Now, numbering means, you know, giving a series of numbers, or you can say giving serial numbers or numbers to a list or a data. So in Excel, there is no special button that is provided which gives numbering for our data. As we already know that Excel does not provide method or tools or a button to give sequential number to the list of data, which means we need to do this by ourselves. So to do the auto numbering in Excel, we need to remember that, you know, our autofill function is to be turned on. Now, by default, it is turned on, but in any case, if we do not have an enabled or mistakenly disabled autofill, here's how something we can re-enable it. Now, we have checked the autofill enabled that there are three methods for Excel auto numbering. First is you need to fill a column, okay, with a series of numbers. Your second will be using row function. Third is using offset function. So first you need to fill in go to the options of file and then fill in the data of options in file, go to options. Okay. Now in that there is an advanced section. Okay. So once you go to the advanced section here, you enable to handle the cell drag and drop. Okay, this one. So here in the advanced section under this, you need to enable and fill in the handle cell drag and drop. You need to do this. Mine has already been enabled. So once you do this, I'll make you start the top three ways you to get the auto numbering in Excel. So there are various ways to get auto numbering in Excel. First, as I say, fill in the column and row, use offset function. We'll start with the first, fill the column with the series numbers. Let's say you have serial number, then you have the name and then the age. So I'll say Ram, Rahim, Ran, Anand, Rahul, just writing a few of the names, Vikas, Neeraj, Gurpreet. I'm just writing few of the names just for your understanding that, you know, this is the example just trying to set for you. And let's say they are in the age group of 35, 36, 25, 26, 30, 31, 28, 29, 27, and 26. So we will try to insert the automatic numbers in Excel column A, column C here. Well, let me just... So we are trying to work on the auto numbering part. So we'll try to insert the automatic numbering in Excel column A. You need to select the cell in which we want to fill this. Okay, in an example here. So the first one is 1 here. So write the numbers that you want to start with. It will be 1 and fill the next cell to the column 2. Okay, once you do that, we did the numbering 1 in cell A here, 41, and in A42 we did with the numbering 2. Okay, so now select the starting value of the cell here. Okay, so the pointer of the dot in the selected sell down by the arrow and click on it and drag it to the desired range. Now just drag this. Now drag this completely. So we have sequential number value. Now the next way we are going to do is with the help of row. See, we will use the same data to demonstrate the sequential numbering of the row function. How we are going to do, see, in cell 2, as we want cell A41, we want to start our automatic numbering Excel. We will select the specific cell. Okay, you need to type is equal to row. Okay, here, so it's A41. It gives us the numbering from A41 because here the row function throws the number of the current row. So to avoid the above situation, we can give the reference row to row function. Okay, A41, or just give it A1. Okay, now the pointer of this date dot over here, this one, selected cell, or drag it to the desired range of the wherever you want to. Just drag this down. So now we have the automatic numbering in Excel for the data using the row function, and then using the offset function is the next way of doing it. Now how to do the offset way, let me show you that. Now using the offset function, we can do auto numbering in Excel using the offset also. Again, we use the same data to demonstrate the offset function. The data is right in front of you. Now as we can see that, you know, there are a couple of things is that, you know, I have tried and removed the text written in here in the first one in the serial number as while using the offset function. Now what you need to do in this particular thing is you need to write a big formula here first. Okay, so how you are going to do is that, you know, is equal to offset, which is, see, this is very less it is used, it's not at all, -1 the row, -0, okay, close the bracket, +1. Okay, there seems to be some problem here. There's a problem with the reference part. So this is basically the formula that you will use, and then you will with the help of this formula, you will drag down all the list from 1 to 11, and then you will have the answer on the offset function. Now, looking at the things that you should remember about the auto numbering in Excel is that, first, Excel does not auto provide the auto numbering. Okay, you need to check for autofill option, that is checked enabled. Third, when you fill a column, when we fill a column with a series of numbers, we make a pattern, and we can either use the starting values as 2 or 4 to make an average or even sequential numbers. I hope you have got a fantastic idea for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining this video. Cheers.